was bad but it's faded. And followers of you now watch TV. What could I do? If you want to get skinny, like really skinny, you might want to watch this.
Morning.
Hey, morning.
Do you think that maybe today you could do the dishes, just clean up around here a bit?
Yeah, of course. I thought the cleaner was coming. Yeah, I'll do it today.
It's all good. Just a bit of a mess. It's all good. I gotta go to work. Okay. I'll see you later.
Okay. Bye. I love you.
Mm-hmm. I love you too.
Just the way you are. You're not like the other one. You just wanna go slow, sit still, and come undone.
G'day, Elgin. How are you?
Yeah, how are you, teacher?
I'm good, thank you.
Yeah, I'm good too, thank you.
How was work?
Busy day.
Busy day, yeah.
How about you? Valentine's Day.
Sorry, say it
again, yeah, Elgin? Happy Valentine's Day.
Yeah, thank you. Happy Valentine's Day.
Everyone talk about Valentine's Day, but I'm very busy.
I know. I'm busy too. I have no partner, so I don't care.
It's okay.
That's okay. I'm happy. That's okay.
Yeah, sometimes you're alone, you're also really happy, you know, you enjoy single life, you know.
Yeah, I do. I really do. Yeah. I love being single. I get to do what I want.
Yes, I got many best friends in Australia. They already, I think, 34 above or 40 or 45. Many, I think about 5 to 6 very best friend, they're just all single.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah, good. Okay.
They are all work or high salary.
Yeah. Sometimes we have to work instead of being married, but that's okay. We can do both, but yeah, work can be very busy. Yeah. That's okay.
Correct.
I wish myself a happy Valentine's Day.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
I wish you a happy Valentine's Day.
Oh, thank you. You too, Alvin. And how are you? G'day, Chloe. How are you today?
G'day, Miss Darling. G'day, Alvin. Today is a long day because we found out a leaking of our toilet.
Oh, no.
And I have to ask the landlord if she's going to fix it or not, because last time she just told me that maybe use the silicone to seal it. And
she told you to do it?
Yeah, because she's in China now. Yeah, it's China. And I have to tell her like what the plumber said to me, and she didn't understand at all, and I have to explain it like so many times and argue with her, is that the right thing to do, because otherwise the walls or everything will damage by the water. And she just says, why change the toilet, just change the rubber. I say he cannot find the piece of the toilet, so he needs to change it, right?
Yeah.
And it's a big job today. And then I just finished a few words about yesterday my news reading, because the plumber comes. So it takes like 5 hours a day to do that.
Oh, yeah, I understand. It takes so long. And the plumber is very expensive.
Yeah, it takes 1475 dollars.
Yeah, wow. And your landlord would not be happy about that.
Yeah, she's not happy. She said, why don't find the Asian plumber, why you find the oldie guy? And I said, I find the best reviews of the plumbers. And because yesterday I asked her that is she gonna find it herself or I should do it, and she said, oh, just go find and tell me what to do. And I found one, and the plumber show up and do the fixing, and she said, oh, why are you it's killing me, you know.
Oh yeah, I understand. That's horrible. Your landlord doesn't understand the situation.
Yeah, because the water can damage the timber, walls, and the maybe the whole structure of the house.
Oh yes.
I don't know, but back in Taiwan, when we do this, we just straight do it. There's no doubt.
Yeah. In Australia as well, it is hard to find a good plumber. Because if they are no good and they only charge you, you know, a little bit, then it will be bad. The job will be bad.
Yeah. So we always say the not the you pay more, you get more, but it's the experience said to me that the expensive one is the better one.
Unfortunately, yes. That's how it is in Australia.
It is what it is.
It is what it is, exactly. Yeah. And everyone in Australia is the same with plumbers. We don't want to call a plumber, but we have to, because water can make so much damage.
Yeah. We finally did it. Yeah.
And especially for a toilet and for the drain, you have to have a working toilet and you have to have a good drain.
Yeah, that's true. Because he said to me that it's the timing is the right time, because we found out the leaking, just the tiny hole between the tiles.
And
he said, if we didn't notice and it let spray,
yes, exactly.
It's really bad. It's gonna be really bad.
Yeah. Well, I'm sorry that happened to you. I hope you can have a relaxing class.
Yeah, I need the cloth to like distracting me. Yeah.
Yes, exactly. You need to be distracted from your bad toilet.
And it already gone, so it's a brand new one.
Yeah, so you can not worry. It's your landlord's problem. So yeah. You can. You've done everything you can. Okay, so today, guys, we are going to do. Oh, someone else is here. Oh, Faru is coming. We are going to do grammar. So, do you remember what we learnt? What was the grammar we learnt last time, last week? Hi, Faru. G'day.
Normalization.
We did. That's true. We learnt normalization. What was the other one?
Perfect. Hi, teacher.
Oh, hello. I can hear you. Hello, Faru. How are you? Oh, she's frozen. So last time we learnt.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, Faru. How are you? Present, perfect.
I'm good, thank you.
Continuous.
Sorry, miss.
That's okay. You are having computer troubles. Okay, so we did present, perfect, continuous tense. Oh, she's gone. So today we are going to do past perfect progressive tense. So when we talk about tense, we are talking about now, yesterday, or tomorrow. So past perfect continuous tense is the future. Right, so you guys can copy this down so you remember what we're doing. This is for you, Faru. I think you would have missed the message in the chat.
Thank you, Miss, because my internet and computers have problems still.
Okay, I understand. So last time you weren't here, Faru, we did present perfect continuous tense.
Yeah,
so you know what that is, but today we're doing past.
Oh,
perfect. So in the past.
Sorry, Miss Darling.
Mm-hmm.
The chatting room, you said past perfect continuous tense is future.
Oh, did I do it wrong?
It's the second one you posted.
Oh, I did, because I was thinking about the future. Yeah, so the second message is present perfect continuous tense is now.
Yeah.
That is what we did last week.
Mm-hmm.
And today we will do past perfect continuous tense, which is when we talk about the past, yesterday or last month or last week.
Yeah.
Okay, so Alvin, can you read?
Yeah, sure. The past perfect continuous also called the past perfect progressive is used for discussing two past actions, where the first action continues to the second action.
Good. So remember, this word is discussing.
Oh, discussing.
Yes. Very good. And you can keep reading, Alvin.
The past perfect continuous is not that common in English, but it is neat, occasionally informal speaking and writing.
Good. This is needed.
Needed.
And this is occasionally.
Occasionally.
Yeah, so just sometimes.
Or sometime, yep.
Yep. Okay. So you guys can copy this. Maybe just copy the first one. I can see Alvin has finished. So Alvin, look at the diagram. Have you finished as well, Faru and Chloe?
Yes.
Good, thank you. Okay, so this line here represents now.
Okay.
We're talking about first action continues to the second action. So this is the first action. It's continuing to the second action. And the example is, I had been studying for 2 hours. That is our first action. By the time he called me last night is our second action. So this person is saying, I've already studied for 2 hours so far, and then he called me. So remember our patterns. This is what we need to write. Had, been, and ing on our verb. So what is the verb? What is the base verb, Faru, in this word?
Base verb, study.
Yep, so just study is our base verb, and then we add ing. So another one could be run, which we turn into running. Okay, so just like we looked at up here, the first action continues to the second action. Two actions occurred in the past. So this is the first action, and it's long. So he's already been studying for 2 hours, and then the friend called. That is the short action. So he was still studying when the friend called, which means the first action, studying, continued at the same time as his friend called. We also need to think about our time markers so that we can understand they had already been studying for 2 hours. By the time, when, and before. Okay, so let's look at our next example. Chloe, can you read all three, please?
I had been studying for 2 hours by the time he called me last night. We had been waiting for more than 3 weeks when the package finally arrived. Before I completed the presentation, I had been talking for over an hour.
Okay, so Chloe, again, what is the first long action which continues to the second short action in this one?
The first action is the studying. Mm-hmm. Study. And the call. He called me. The call is the second one.
Yeah. So this is the long action continuing into the short action. And what about this one, Chloe?
Waiting is the first one, long one. And the package arrive is the second one, not short one.
Exactly. So they had already been waiting for 3 whole weeks. They've been waiting at home for 3 weeks, and then the package arrived. And the last one, Chloe, can you try to figure this one out?
Talking for over an hour is the long action.
Good.
And then completed the presentation is the short one.
Exactly. So even though it looks different than these two sentences, the short action, the long action is down here. We can see had been talking is the same as our pattern. All right, so Alvin?
Yes.
What is the base verb in this word?
Wait.
Very good. And this one, Alvin?
Talk.
Excellent. Good work. Okay, so you guys can, you can print this. This is in your Moodle. Have you got Red 3, Faru?
Sorry, did you?
Have you got Red 3 in your Moodle?
I have. Which one?
Let's see, I'll show you.
I haven't.
Why not? Have you got this one, Faru?
No.
Okay, we need to give you that one. Okay, I'll fix that up for you later, Faru.
Okay. Teacher, can I ask you something? Can I need student verification letter?
Yeah, are you yes?
Yeah, I need that.
Okay. Can I email it to you?
Yes, please.
Yeah, no worries. Okay, I'll do that for you.
Thank you.
Okay, so in your Moodle, you've got grammar here. So you guys can print this worksheet. So you don't need to keep copying everything. Okay. Okay, so Faru, can you read this, please?
When forming the past perfect in English, the independent clause uses had plus been plus info, and the dependent clause takes the simple past. Remember that the dependent clause can come before or after the independent clause. When it comes before the independent clause, use a comma. For example, she had been talking for 2 hours by the time he asked to use the phone. Second, by the time he asked to use the phone, she had been talking for 2 hours.
Okay, good. So we can see here, this is the independent clause. And this is the simple past, the dependent clause. So we have two tenses here. We have past perfect continuous, and we have simple past. Okay, so the dependent clause is first. The independent clause is second, so no comma. So when we say a dependent clause, if I write she had been talking for 2 hours, that's not really a sentence because it needs to have more information. And here is the information. But this one, the independent clause, comes after, so there is a comma. Okay, Chloe, can you read this?
Yep. Sometimes the dependent clause is just an adverb phrase of time and not a complete sentence with a password. Examples of typical phrases include by, July 2010, by 6 at last night, etc. By August 1998, she had been living in California for 8 years. They had been preparing for the meeting for 24 hours by 10 a.m. yesterday.
Right, so we haven't used had or been, but this is a time marker, by. And English, we learn the rule, but then we find out there is an exception to the rule. Okay, so this is an exception. So by, I can say, by the time I finished high school, I had been working for 2 years. So same thing. All right, Alvin.
This word tense has three parts to it. Here's now, it is formed.
How
it is
formed.
Form. Past perfect has plus past participle has studied.
Had.
Sorry?
Had. You said has. It's had.
Okay. Had. Study.
Good.
Continues. Be. Word. ing words. Be studying.
Good.
The past participle of be. The first part of the continues from. Beer. Been final result has been ing word.
Okay, try to say verb.
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 Yeah, that's better. Okay, so we can see that we've got past perfect is had. We've got the past participle of be is been, which is here. And then we've also got continuous. Remember, we use continuous in present perfect because we had to put ing on the base verb. So this is your, always your rule. This is the pattern that you need to remember. So we can see it here. So past perfect is had. And then it continues. Had been. We need to know it's continuing. This is what's telling us. And this is the ing. So this is the past. Okay, so the simple past perfect. This is the continuous. That makes the verb continue. And then this tells us that it's continuing. We can't say I had studying. We have to say I had been studying. So once again, we've got past perfect, which is simple, past perfect continuous. Look at our diagram. We've got two separate events. They're not linked. Over here, they're continuing. So this one, finished. So this is done. This is over before the second pass. So think of this as eating dinner, and then this is having a shower. You finished dinner, all done. And you're having your shower before you go to bed. But over here, you can say, I had been eating dinner for an hour by the time or before I had a shower. Or even, I had been eating dinner before I had a shower. You can also see that the time markers can be used in both. Okay, we don't say after or continuous. All right, let's look at our examples. Faru, can you read this one? This is past perfect. And look at the patterns while you're reading, Faru. Okay.
My friend had texted me 5 times before I answered. I had finished dinner by the time he called me last night. By the time she got home, someone had fixed the door. Had you already met clients when I invited you for coffee yesterday?
Good, and don't forget your ED. That's important because see, ED here, it needs to be finished.
Oh, yeah.
This is a fixed, texted, it's done. Okay, now let's go to Chloe. Can you read this?
Yep. My sister had been studying English for 11 years before she entered university. We had been waiting since 5 p.m. when she finally arrived 2 hours later. When he called me at midnight, I hadn't been sleeping for very long. Had you been traveling all night by the time you got to your hotel?
Beautiful. So we've got had, been, and the ing verb on study. All right, let's do some exercises. Okay, so we're going to write the past perfect continuous form of the verbs. So this is our verb, and this is our past perfect continuous form of the verb. Okay, so Alvin, can you read the example?
Yes. By the time she called me, I had been doing my homework for 3 hours.
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 Good. Okay, so can you tell me where the long action is?
Long action. I've my homework for 3 hours.
Yep, this one here.
Oh, very long.
Yeah. Yeah, so I had been, this is all the same. I had been doing my homework for 3 hours. That is one action, the long action. So what is this action, Alvin?
This one is by the time she called. This one is perfect, present perfect past. You tell me I wrong.
That's okay. That's okay. Let's look back here. Okay, so the first, or we have the long action
mm-hmm.
and the short action. So oh. 1, 2.
Time mark.
Yeah, so this is our long action.
Yeah.
And this is our short action. And you're right, we've got a time marker by the time.
Oh.
That's telling us when.
Mm.
Called. All right, let's try number one, Chloe.
Yep. She had been attending university for 6 years before she graduated.
Beautiful. And where is our long action?
Attending university.
For 6 years?
Yeah, yeah.
And where is our short action?
Graduated.
Before she graduated. Oh, mm-hmm. Before she graduated is our short action.
Yeah.
Okay, number two, please, Faru.
He had been sleeping for 9 hours by 8 a.m.
Good. And what is our long action?
Sleeping for 9 hours by 8 a.m.
No, we have two actions, remember?
For 9 hours?
Yes, correct.
By 8 a.m.
So, so our long action is he had been sleeping for 9 hours. Our short action, by 8 a.m. Okay. Alvin, number three.
By the time she got to my house,
remember your pattern? Look at these ones. And this is what we need to change.
Oh, I has been cleaning for
ages.
Ages.
And what is our short action?
Short action. She got to my house.
Good, yep, that's it. And our long action?
I has been cleaning for ages.
Excellent, good, Alvin. All right, Chloe, number four.
We had hanging out for 45 minutes before you joined us.
Remember your pattern.
Joined us.
No.
In
here, what is the pattern? We've got had.
Had been hanging out.
Good, very good.
Yeah.
Hanging out. So hang is our base verb. So we can't say hang outing. We say hanging out. And where is our long action?
Had been hanging out for 45 minutes.
Beautiful. And where is our short action?
Before you join us.
Excellent. Good work. All right. Number five, Faru.
I had been living.
This word, you need to put that somewhere.
I had. I had been living not here long before I moved to a new house.
Close, but no cigar. I had not been living here long. I had not been living here. I had not been studying long before I got a new job. Okay, and what is our long action, Faru?
Long action.
This one's tricky.
Before. Before I moved to a new house.
No, I can see why you're saying that, but we need to stick to our rules. So I had not been living here long. So don't think of it as what the words are telling you. Think of it like a pattern. You need to have, this is what we're talking about. This is long and it's continuing in the past. Before I move to a new house. Think of it like the two parts of the sentence are coming together. Okay, so the long action, you could easily say I had been living here, you would say for a long time, and that would be the same. It would still be the long action. Okay, number six, who are we up to? Alvin.
My friend has been working at our company for 8 years before he quit.
Okay, very good. That's perfect. And where is our long action?
Long action is our company for 8 years. My friend has been working at our company.
Yep, perfect, good. And our short action?
Short is for 8 years before he quit.
Nearly, it's just before he quit. Our long action is my friend had been working at our company for 8 years.
Okay, understand. Thank you.
Action before he quit.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna move my screen.
Can I take a photo?
Oh no! Too late.
Sorry. It's okay.
let me do it real quick. It's a bit annoying with this.
Oh, I take notes, so I maybe just send the picture to Alvin.
Oh, you're awesome, Chloe. Yes.
Thank you.
No worries, I will send it back to you.
Thank you.
All right, you can share it with Faru as well if you like. So do it for everyone. Thank you so much, Chloe. That's awesome.
Yeah, no worries.
Thank you.
All right, so number 7, we'll go back to Chloe when she's ready.
The security guard had been patrolling the building all night by the time I got to the office.
Okay, yep, that's good. You said it right. It's just this word is pronounced patrolling.
Patrolling, yeah.
Yeah.
What is the meaning of patrolling?
So a security guard will walk around the building.
Oh, yeah, I understand.
Yep, checking doors, making sure no one has broken in. That is patrolling.
Okay.
If you were in prison, the prison guards would be patrolling the walls.
Yes.
No one can escape. Sorry, I put two L's there. Hang on, that's not right. Right. Number 8, please, Faru.
By 11 p.m. last night, we had been sleeping for only an hour.
Good. And can you tell me the short action?
Short action.
I've just mixed it up.
Had been sleeping?
No.
For only an hour?
No. So we've got two actions happening. We've got a long one. We had been sleeping for only an hour.
And our, by
11
p.m. last night.
So this is our short action, and we're continuing the two actions. All right, number 9, please. Chloe, sorry. No, not Chloe, Alvin.
You miss me?
I know, you wish.
Number 9 is by the time he had been waiting long when she finally arrived.
That was a good try, Alvin. That was very good, but no.
It's put the since he.
So you got this part correct. So this is good. Had been waiting. Okay. This is a question. Would you like me to help you?
Yeah, it's I put since he has been waiting since. No.
No, because it's a question, we can't use since.
Oh, he's asking.
He's asking, yeah.
When he has been wedding, he can. I use when.
I've mixed you up. I've done it wrong.
Oh.
Sorry, Alvin, I mixed you up.
It's okay. Don't say sorry.
Okay, so what's missing now?
Oh, has.
Had.
Sorry, I pronounced very bad.
No, you're doing well. No, don't say sorry.
I asked you to say sorry.
I know. See, it doesn't matter. We all make mistakes. Mistakes are how we learn. I just learned something new then. So say the whole sentence, Alvin.
Has he been waiting long when she finally arrived?
Very good. You got it. We got it together.
We got it. Thank you.
Exactly. So can you tell me the long action?
Long action is has he been waiting? Long.
Yes. Yes, long.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so what is the short one?
Short one is finally alive.
Yeah, we need to say all of it. When she finally arrived.
Okay. So when she finally arrived.
Yeah, this is important, this word. This makes us know it continues.
Okay.
Okay, number 10, please, Chloe.
Had the children been playing quietly before their mother got home?
Perfect. And would you have gotten that if Alvin and me had not made a mistake?
Pardon?
Do you think you would have answered that correct if Alvin and me didn't make a mistake?
I don't quite get you. Sorry.
Okay. So did you know what the answer was for 9 already?
I know the answer. Sorry. Yeah.
That's okay. I'm just trying to find out if you already knew the answer.
Oh, no, I don't know the answer.
Okay, so when Alvin and me made a mistake, did it help you?
Oh yeah, because when Alvin said it's when or where or whatever in front of the he,
yeah.
And I also guess, oh, maybe it's when he.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then when you finish with Alvin, and I notice the pattern of the sentence.
Yep. See, Alvin, mistakes are how we learn.
Yes, and more understand now.
So 3 people made a, well, Chloe didn't make a mistake, but 3 people learned. And I bet Faru learned as well.
Yes.
All right. So you guys can take a photo of 7, 8, 9, and 10 before I clear it off.
I did, but sometimes we still will little bit confusing about the long and the short, you know, teacher.
I understand. Remember, it's not the words I'm trying to ask about. It's how the sentence has been put together.
Yes, if I just see or watch the word, I think I will be wrong. If I just read the sentence, I can get maybe 70 to 80% the long and the short.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So
you need to more practice, you can more understand.
Exactly, Alvin, that's exactly right. You can't do this in one lesson, because like anything, like you can't have one driving lesson and then drive a car forever perfectly.
Yeah.
Never, ever. So you just need to go back and practice where we started, which is this one. So two actions occurred in the past. Remember I said eating dinner and having a shower. So if I say I had been eating dinner for 1 hour before taking a shower. So my long action is I had been eating dinner. That is my long action. And my short action is before my shower. It's only the way the sentence is put together. Keep remembering that, Alvin. It's only the sentence. We can say anything in these examples. We can use anything. I can use words like long, or I what can I use for short? The priest sang a short hymn in church before we finished. The long action is still had been singing. The priest had been singing a hymn in church is still the long action.
Teacher, can I say if I say I has been sleeping for maybe an hour before, or say last night he called me, like this is okay? Can or not?
Can you write that into chat for me?
Can, sure.
Exactly what you said.
Thank you, Chloe, for sharing with us.
Yeah, thank you, Chloe. That's kind.
No worries, everyone. We just keep learning, right?
Exactly. We can all help each other. Farooq, that last one is what we are looking at now, which you don't have yet, okay?
Yes. Sure.
You can save that to your computer, or you can print that.
Yes, done.
Just help Alvin, and then we'll have a break. No, you can only say I slept for an hour. It's a good question, actually, Alvin, because what you've done is you've tried to use just present perfect. I'm so confused with the P sounds. You just used past perfect. I slept for an hour last night. is past perfect tense. Okay, but if you wanted to make it into past perfect continuous, you would say, I had been sleeping for, let's say, only 2 hours before I woke up this morning, just so we can understand a little bit more. I just added some words, and that is past perfect continuous tense. Does that help you, Alvin?
Yes, thank you, teacher.
Yeah, you sure? It doesn't matter if you're confused, we can still work on it.
Yes, too many. I can't receive all. Now okay.
Okay, good. Alrighty, let's have a break, guys. And we'll do some more questions. That's not the right one, is it?
It's been days now, and you change your mind again. It feels like years, and I can tell how time can bend your ideas. And the boys go on and on and on and on. And the boys go on and on and on and on. And there's gold falling from the ceiling of this world, falling from the heartbeat of this girl, falling from the things we should have learned, falling from the things we could have heard. Well, it's been days now, and you change your mind again. Oh, the cracks in the walls reminds you of things we said. Tell you that I won't hurt you this time, but it's just safer to keep you in this heart of mine. And the boys go on and on and on and on. And the boys go on and on and on.
Okay, let's go, guys. Okay, Alvin and Faru, let's come back. So now we will find the error. Do you know what error means, Chloe?
Mistakes.
Frog. Yeah, it's probably just mistake.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's find the mistakes.
Sorry, I just come back. I go toilet.
It's okay. It was a short break. So this time, Alvin, we're going to find the error, which is the mistake.
Okay.
All right. So can you read this? These are our instructions.
Okay. Find one error in each sentence and correct it on the line below.
Very good. This is just sentence.
Okay.
Okay, sentence is one, sentences is more.
Oh, understand.
Yeah. All right, now can you read the example, Alvin?
Sure. By the time my friend arrived, I had been watching TV for 2.5 hours. By the time my friend arrived, I had been watching TV for 2.5 hours.
So what changed in the sentence?
Alive, it changed alive word.
Mm-hmm.
And the other one, I think is the same.
Very good, yeah. So arrive is present.
Yes.
When will he arrive? Arrived with ed.
Arrived.
Yeah. Is past.
Is past.
He arrived at 2 o'clock.
Okay.
That is the past. Okay. Chloe, can you please read number one?
My parents had traveling for 6 months when their motor home broke down.
Okay, so where is the mistake?
You should add a bin between had and traveling.
Very good.
Yeah.
Okay, number two, are you there, Faru? Okay, number two, Alvin?
Yes. By the time, you want me to read first or?
Yes, so read and then answer.
Okay, by the time John had been getting home, his friend Matt has been watching the game for an hour.
Good. What is the answer? What do we need to change to make it correct?
By the time John has been get home.
You're close.
You're close. Can you help me?
Yeah, so we just need to change had been getting into one verb. So it's got. By the time John got home.
Mm.
Okay, that's a hard one, Alvin.
Yeah.
but we changed. So think of this as one whole verb, had been getting. Mm. We changed it to got.
This one is a past.
It's still the past, yes.
It's still the past, yes.
Yeah. So this is still the past, but we don't use our rule in this sentence. We have to use got. It means the same thing.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Number three, Faru. This is your example up here. So can you read number three and then answer? We need to find out where the mistake is in this sentence. This is wrong. We need to make it right.
She had been studying English for 10 years when she graduated. She had studied.
We still need had been. What do we do with our base verb?
Study.
Yeah, and how do we need to change it so it looks like this one?
Studying.
Very good. Studying.
English.
Yeah. All right, number four, Chloe.
You had been playing the drums for 8 years by the time you turn 18.
Okay, what do we need to change?
Had, have to had.
Very good. You had been playing. Okay, number five, Alvin.
Jacob has been living in China for 5 months before he returns home.
What do we need to change? Where is the mistake?
Jacob has been live in China, LIVED, is correct?
No. Good try. But had been living is correct.
It's correct.
Had been living is our rule.
Yep.
Had been playing, had been studying, had been traveling. So that stays the same. So we need to look down here in our short action.
Oh, we changed the returns.
Yeah. What do you know what we change it to?
RETURNED.
Yeah, very good. Returned home. And we did that because ED is the past.
Yes.
Okay, so you can take a photo. Okay, number six, Faru. Oh, you're on mute, Faru.
Sorry, Gigi.
That's okay.
I had been reading for half an hour by the time she came over. I had been reading. I have been reading.
You need to look at your time marker in this sentence.
Yes. I had been reading for half an hour by the time.
Very good.
It came over.
That's really good. Okay, number 7, Chloe.
Yeah. By the time my daughter turned 19, I had been I have been teaching her to drive since for 3 years.
Yeah, so you changed it there.
Yeah.
So we take since away and we need to put in for. All right, number 8, please, Alvin.
The staff members had been working for 9 hours straight by the time their manager got back to the office.
Okay, so I think you changed it already. What did you change? I think you did it and you didn't even realize. What is our rule?
Attention.
We've got had been teaching, had been reading. So what does this need to be?
Has been working.
Very good. You said it and you didn't even know.
And one more question. And the back is he right, by the times their manager got back to the office. Mm-hmm. Is it got why they want to put got back to the office? It's no go back to the office.
Because so the word go means the present or the future. So I can't say yesterday I go to the shops. I can only say yesterday I went to the shops.
Yeah.
Or yesterday I got back from the shops early.
Understand. Yes. But normally if we speak to someone or saying, I will say, yesterday I went to the market.
Yep, that's exactly right. So yeah, that's yesterday. So that's the past.
Is I use the got, I want to use a got back together, right?
I don't understand the question.
The meaning is a manager got back. I want to use got back. Can I use manager got to the office?
No. You can only say that if you put something else with it. So you can say the manager got to the office.
Okay. Okay, understand.
Yeah, you can't say the manager got to the office.
Okay, understand now. Yep.
Okay. So you guys can take a photo. right, so what are we going to do for exercise 3? Oru?
A past perfect continuous sentence. Read sentence using the past perfect continuous tense. The first sentence should start with a dependent clause. And the second should start with an independent clause. What's your punctuation?
Yep, that's good. Punctuation. So punctuation means full stops, like this guy here. Uppercase letters. And also commas. So we have a comma here and other things. But we're going to just think about commas because when we go back up to our instructions, which is this one. Okay, these are our examples. She had been talking for 2 hours. But this one is after, sorry, when the dependent clause, okay, so this is our dependent clause. We have to have something after it. We could say he asked to use the phone. So he asked to use the phone. Okay, so that is now that is an independent clause. But if we put by the time, if we use our time marker, it becomes a dependent clause. Okay, so I have not put an uppercase B because it's not a proper sentence when I have the time marker. By the time he asked to use the phone, it needs to have something after it or something before it. It cannot be alone in a sentence. Okay, so I'll put here, this is stand alone sentence. Okay, so we can say he asked to use the phone and we're done. We don't have to put anything else with it. So it's independent. It stands alone. But this one, by the time, this is our continuous part of the sentence. It cannot stand alone anymore. Okay, so you can take a photo of this and add this to your notes on your worksheet. Are you copying, Chloe, or can I clear this? Thank you. So we're going to put this into practice with exercise 3. So we're going to write our sentences using past perfect continuous tense, which is what we are learning today. The first sentence should start with a dependent clause, which means it cannot stand alone. And the second sentence should start with an independent clause, which means it can stand alone. So we're thinking about joining two sentences together. Okay, so can you read the example, please, Faru?
Example, we go on holiday, it rained 2 weeks. By the time we went on holiday, it had been raining for 2 weeks. It had been raining for 2 weeks by the time we went on holiday.
Okay, so where is the dependent clause in this sentence?
Dependent clause, the first one, by the time we went on holiday.
Yep, so we need a comma.
Yes.
Because it comes before the independent clause. We can say this sentence all by itself. It had been raining for 2 weeks. Done. So where is the dependent clause in this sentence, Faru?
It had been raining for 2 weeks.
No.
Oh, sorry, Richard. Independent or independent?
Dependent. It cannot stand alone.
It had been raining for 2 weeks.
No, that is our independent. It can just be a sentence. It had been raining for 2 weeks. Done.
Oh.
So our dependent clause is this one, the same as this one? Okay, but we have no comma because it comes after the independent clause. Let's just write some notes for you guys. So this is the dependent clause, and this one is the independent clause. The dependent clause comes after. Comes before the independent clause. Okay, so the question you need to ask is, what is the dependent clause in the sentence? Okay, so you guys can take a photo of my notes. so you can keep track. Are you okay, Faru?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah. Are you copying?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, can I clear this off now? Thanks. So let's try this one, number one. This is our information. We want to write it as a sentence using past perfect continuous tense. Chloe, can you try?
Yeah. Before they drove around, they had been asking directions for hours.
Yeah.
Not right.
Say that again. Say it again for me.
Before they drove around. There's a comma there.
Good.
They have been asking directions for hours.
So, you're following all the rules.
I used the wrong time markers, right?
kind of. Think about it. So, before they drove around, they had been asking directions for hours. Probably would ask for directions and get an answer. That's telling me they did not get an answer. And then they drove around. So it is correct, but it would be better putting it this way. They had been driving around for hours before they asked for questions. Direction. Okay, so you did do a good job in the first one, but it would make more sense that they're driving around lost for hours. Yeah. So you know how sometimes you have a cranky driver and they won't ask for directions, and the passenger says, "Stop and ask for directions." And the driver says, "No, we'll find it." This is what's happening in this situation.
Yeah.
Okay, but then they did ask for directions. So this is our what, Chloe?
Is the independent clause.
Clause. So this is our independent clause. And then this is our dependent clause. We cannot say before they ask for questions, before directions. So this is what Chloe's done here. You've put it after, but it makes more sense putting it before the dependent clause. So we do not need a comma. Okay, do you want to try number two, Alvin?
Lisa has been cannot too difficult for me.
Yeah, this is a hard one. So we can just say this time last week, Lisa lay in bed with the flu for 6 days. So this is getting a bit harder, but we can still see that we've got a dependent clause and an independent clause. The dependent clause is this time last week. The independent clause is Lisa lay in bed with the flu for 6 days. So remember we had the short action and the long action. They are the same as dependent clause and independent clause. So in this case, our short action, this time last week, it's a dependent clause. So we need to have a comma because it comes before the independent clause, which is our long action. right, let's try number three.
Teacher, can I ask you some questions? If we say this time last week, when we can use these sentences, talk to time people or on the spot or now or
So we're still working with past perfect continuous tense, so we're still talking about the past, which is why I changed lie to lay.
That one,
yep, so it's the past.
Okay.
Lie, I will lie in bed all day now. But lay is in the past.
Okay.
You can only, yep. Yes, Chloe?
Miss Darling, should we don't use that had been lying on the bed, in the bed, or just use lay in the bed?
Let's try it, Chloe. Let's see what happens. Lisa had been lying got a brain freeze. Yeah, it's that. Lisa had been lying in bed with the flu for 6 days. This time last week. Okay, does that work, Chloe?
I'm just not sure about the answer, so I just ask you.
Well, let's work it out. So where is the dependent clause?
This time last week.
Yep. Good. So it's at the end. And where is the independent clause?
Lisa had been lying in bed with flu for 6 days.
Yep. So does the sentence work?
I thought so, but a bit weird about the last few words.
This time last week.
Yeah.
So we can say Lisa had been lying in bed with the flu for 6 days this time last week. So this is a common phrase in English. This time last year, so in the middle of February 2022, this time last year, I was in Bali. I wasn't.
I wish you were.
Yes. So do you understand, like, that's a phrase, that's a common phrase. This time last week, I was too busy to go to the gym. So this time, which is Tuesday, okay, this time last week, so last Tuesday, I was too busy to go to the gym. I'm not busy now. So Lisa's not sick now because this is in the past.
Okay.
So it does work.
Can I say, teacher, can I say this time last year we go to holiday together.
We went.
We went on holiday together. No, we went for camping together. Can I say like that?
This time last year, we went camping together.
After we put the place name is okay, right?
We went camping
together, and I want to say about the place name, or let's say I go to Krampen to camping. Can I?
Okay. How do I spell that word?
Gram.
Oh, Grampians.
Grampians, yes. Pians.
We went camping in the, and it's a capital letter because it's the name of a place.
Okay.
Grampians together. We could also say this time last year we went camping at, I'll just make up a word, Rainbow Falls. So that's also a name of a place.
Rainbow Falls.
We went camping at Rainbow Falls together. So, Alvin, it depends on the place you're talking about. And it also depends on the action. So if I was talking about Disneyland, this time last year, we were in Disneyland. Okay, so we were inside. Think of that like inside. So the Grampians is a really big place, right?
Yes.
So you were inside the Grampians.
Yes.
So you use in. But when it's a place like Rainbow Falls.
Yes.
That is just a small waterfall.
Yes.
Okay. That's the name of the waterfall. So you were at it. Think of you as sitting next to the waterfall.
Understand.
Or we could say park. Okay. If we said park, then we need to change this to in. Because we're inside the Rainbow Falls Park. That makes it a bigger place. Yeah, so we're inside Disneyland. We can also say for Disneyland, this time last year, we were at Disneyland. But in both of these cases, I did not say what we were doing in Disneyland. Hey, you know what we do in Disneyland. Everybody knows that. But we could say we were having fun at Disneyland. We can also say having fun. Having fun. But I would prefer to say side for this one. If I still had in, I would want to change it to inside. But that's a really good question. So just remember it's the place and what you're doing that changes the grammar. All right, let's go Faru's already gone.
Miss Dolly, so so the question number two, the correct answer is the first sentence, right? The second one is not make sense.
They're both correct, Chloe. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But this one is more common.
Okay.
If I was talking to my friends, I would say this time last week, Lisa lay in bed with the flu for 6 days.
So the dependent clause this all the time. This time last week, the dependent clause is in front of the independent clause, right? In this sentence.
In this sentence, yeah, but it's not an exact science.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so it can change. You can still say it this way, but this is more common.
Okay, yeah, noted. Okay.
And just to keep saying this time last week, this is probably even more common, had been lying in bed the flu for 6 days. So that's probably the best sentence, Chloe.
Yeah.
All right, so you guys can take a quick photo if you want to, and then we'll say goodbye.
Yeah, already.
Already? Good. Chloe, yeah. You done?
Yep.
Yeah. All right. Thank good you night. So much for your hard work today, guys. I hope you good enjoyed night. It.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you.
Good night.
Good night,
everyone. Bye.